Hello everyone. Myself Dr. Madhura, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Mathematics at Sai Vidya Institute of Technology. Today, I'll be teaching a topic in discrete mathematical structures. The subject code is 18CS36. In module 2, that is fundamental principles of counting, I'll be teaching about binomial and multinomial theorems. So let us first look into definition for binomial theorem. Binomial theorem for a positive integral index is given by x plus y whole power n is equal to summation r is equal to 0 to n ncr x power r y power n minus r. The same in turn can be written as summation r is equal to 0 to n ncr x power n minus r into y power r, where x and y are real numbers. Let us note a point about binomial coefficients. The numbers ncr, where r takes the value from 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to n, whose coefficients are of the form nc0, nc1, nc2, etc. up to ncn, in the above result are called as binomial coefficients. Now, let us learn the definition for multinomial theorem. For positive integers n and k, multinomial theorem is stated as below. So we have more than two terms in our expansion, which is x1 plus x2 plus x3, etc. up to xk whole power n is equal to summation n factorial divided by n1 factorial into n2 factorial into n3 factorial, etc. up to nk factorial, multiplied by x1 power n1, x2 power n2 into x3 power n3, etc. up to xk power nk. So we observe that in the expansion we have totally k terms. So if it is two terms involved in the expansion, then it is binomial theorem application. If more than two terms are involved in the required expansion, then it comes to multinomial theorem. There is a restriction about the values of n1 to nk. So the sum of all n1 to nk terms should be equal to n. That is n1 plus n2 plus n3, etc. up to nk is equal to n. Now, let's see problems on binomial and multinomial theorem. First question, find the coefficient of x power 0 in the expansion of 3x square minus 2 by x whole power 15. So we need to find the coefficient of x power 0 in the expansion of this. We observe that there are two terms in the required expansion, right, which can be compared of the form x plus y whole power n. So in place of x, we have 3x square. In place of y, we have minus 2 by x. Is compared with whole power n. So n value here is 15. So this problem is an application of binomial theorem. So let us first write down the binomial theorem, which is x plus y whole power n is equal to summation r is equal to 0 to n ncr x power r y power n minus r. Now let us substitute the values of x, y and n on comparing with the requirement. So our requirement is 3x square minus 2 by x whole power 15. So taking in place of x, 3x square. In place of y, we take minus 2 by x. In place of n, we take 15. So the same is substituted in the right hand part of the formula. So summation r is equal to 0 to 15. 15 cr, because n is equal to 15. 15 cr into 3x square whole power r. X value is 3x square. Y power n minus r. Y value is minus 2 by x. Along with the sign we have compared, and y value is predicted here as negative. So y value is minus 2 by x whole power 15 minus r. So n value is 15. 15 minus r. Now let us split the terms. 15 cr under the summation. 3 power r into x power 2 whole power r gives us x power 2r. X power 2 whole power r gives x power 2r. Here the constant is minus 2. So along with the constant 2, I'll consider minus sign. So minus 2 whole power 15 minus r multiplied by 1 by x whole power 15 minus r. So 1 by x whole power 15 minus r is the next term. Now in order to combine the powers of x, 1 by x whole power 15 minus r can also be written as x power r minus 15. 1 by x is nothing but x inverse. So we have x inverse whole power 15 minus r, which can be written as x power r minus 15. So that in the next step, we can combine the expression of x. So we have x power 2r into x power r minus 15. Since the base are same in a product, the powers can be combined. So 2r plus r is 3r minus 15 as it is. Now looking into the requirement, we have to obtain the coefficient of x power 0, x power 0. So 3r minus 15 is equated to 0, so that r value is equal to 5 on simplification. Our requirement is x power 0. So in order to obtain the coefficient of x power 0, we substitute r value as 5. So that 3r minus 15 goes to 0. So substituting r is equal to 5, the coefficient of x power 0 will be, so wherever r is there, we are considering r value as 5. So we get 15 c5 into 3 power 5 into minus 2 whole power 15 minus 5 is 10. So simplifying this, the required answer will be 74 crore 72 lakh 42,496. We'll see another problem on binomial theorem. So we need to find the coefficient of x power 12 in the expansion of x cube into 1 minus 2x whole power 10. So our requirement is the coefficient of x power 12 in this expansion. Again, we observe that there are two terms involved in the required expansion. So it's an application of binomial theorem. So first we will write on the formula for binomial theorem. And now we consider the expression first only for 1 minus 2x whole power 10. Later we multiply in the next step by x cube. It's a multiplier outside for this expansion, which is of the form x plus y whole power n. So we take x value as 1, y value as minus 2x, and n value as 10, substitute in the right hand side of the formula, which gives us summation r is equal to 0 to 10, 10 cr, n value is 10, so 10 cr x power r. X value is considered here as 1. So 1 power r. Y value is on comparison minus 2x. So minus 2x whole power 10 minus r. But since our requirement is x cube into 1 minus 2x whole power 10, we multiply by x cube on both sides. So multiplying by x cube on both the sides, we'll get the below step. And now we observe that x powers can be combined. Since the base are same in a product, the powers are added. So we have 10 plus 3, 13 minus r. We have simultaneously taken into consideration the constants, power separate, and then the variable power separate. So minus 2 whole power 10 minus r into x power 10 minus r was considered. X power 10 minus r multiplied with x cube gives us x power 13 minus r. Now, our requirement is x power 12. Our requirement is x power 12. So in order to obtain x power 12, we choose a relevant value for r. R ranges from 0 to 10, but we need to choose a relevant, a particular value for r based on the requirement. So our requirement is to obtain the coefficient of x power 12. So in order to get x power 12 here, we choose r is equal to 1. So that we get 10c1 into minus 2 whole power 9. Simplifying this, the coefficient, required coefficient is minus 5120. So we had to choose r is equal to 1 in order to obtain the coefficient of x power 12. So taking r is equal to 1, a particular value for r, we obtained 10c1 minus 2 whole power 10 minus 1. 10 minus 1 is 9, so minus 2 whole power 9. This, on simplifying using a calculator, we can obtain minus 5120. Next problem. Next problem is to find the coefficient of x power 11 into y power 4 into z square in the expansion of 2x cube minus 3xy square plus z square whole power 6. We observe in the required expansion that more than two terms are involved. 2x cube is one term, minus 3xy square is second term, third term is z square. Since more than two terms are involved, it's an application of multinomial theorem. So let us first write down the formula for multinomial theorem, which is given by x1 plus x2 plus x3 etc. up to xk whole power n is equal to summation n factorial divided by n1 factorial into n2 factorial into n3 factorial etc. up to nk factorial. This is the general formula for up to k terms, multiplied by x1 power n1 into x2 power n2 into x3 power n3 etc. up to xk power nk. Now, since only three terms are involved for us, we'll take x1 as 2x cube. We will take x2 as minus 3xy square, and we take x3 as z square. We also recall the condition for multinomial theorem that the sum of n terms up to k, that is n1 plus n2 plus n3 etc. up to nk, should be always equal to n. So considering x1 as 2x cube, x2 as minus 3xy square, and x3 as z square, whole power n, n value is compared and obtained as 6. we apply in the right hand side formula. So summation, n value is 6, so 6 factorial in the numerator, divided by, since we have only 3 terms in the required expansion, we take only n1 factorial into n2 factorial into n3 factorial. So we take only the product of 3 terms, because in the required expansion there are only 3 terms involved. Multiplied by, in place of x1 we have 2x cube, so 2x cube power n1. In place of x2 we have minus 3xy square, so minus 3xy square whole power n2. In place of x3 we have z square, so z square whole power n3. Now we need to choose a relevant value for n1, n2, n3. So before doing that, I'll just split the terms, constants, powers first, and then multiply it by the variable powers, so that here we need to combine the variables. So we have 2 power n1 multiplied with minus 3 power 2 minus 3 power n2 multiplied with x power 3n1 into x power n2 into y power 2 whole power n2 gives us y power 2n2 multiplied by z power 2n3. So that we can now combine the powers of x. In the product, since the base are same, powers can be added. So we have x power 3n1 multiplied with x power n2, which gives us x power 3n1 plus n2, multiplied by this y powers and the z powers as it is. Now, let us choose a relevant value for n1, n2, n3 based on our requirement. So the requirement is to obtain the coefficient of x power 11 into y power 4 into z power 2. So first let us choose the value for n3. So when we compare, we have z power 2 n3 and our requirement is z square. So on comparison, n3 value should be chosen as 1. Similarly, we have y power 2 n2 and our requirement is y power 4. So n2 should be chosen as 2, so that we get y power 4. Now keeping these values of n2 and n3 in mind, we will be equating this 3n1 plus n2 to 11, so that we get n1 is equal to 3. I repeat, since the requirement or the coefficient of x power 11 into y power 4 into z square is the requirement, we choose n3 as 1, n2 as 2, and hence we must have 3n1 plus n2 equal to 11. So this power of x should be 11. So substituting the n2 value already chosen, that is 2, we get 3n1 plus 2 is equal to 11, or 3n1 is equal to 9, or n1 value will be 3. So these n1, n2, n3 values we are going to substitute in the previous expression. Observe that n1 plus n2 plus n3 is equal to n value. n1 is 3 plus 2 plus 1. Gives us 6, and we observe that n value is equal to 6. We observe n value is equal to 6. Now substituting these in the previous step, we can obtain 6 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 2 factorial into 1 factorial multiplied by 2 cube into minus 3 whole square into x power 11 y power 4 into z square. So this on simplification gives us 4320 multiplied by x power 11 y power 4 z square. So thus the required coefficient is 4320. we need to just write down the coefficient of x power 11, y power 4 and z square, which is 4320. We'll see another problem on multinomial theorem, which is to find the coefficient of a square, b cube, c square, d power 5 in the expansion of a plus 2b minus 3c plus 2d plus 5 whole power 16. So it's an application of multinomial theorem, since we observe that in the required expansion, there are more than two terms involved. We have actually five terms, a, 2b, minus 3c, 2d and 5. So we have five terms actually. So it's an application of multinomial theorem. So first let us write down the theorem statement followed by the condition, that is n1, n2, n3, sum of all n1 to nk terms is equal to n. Now, we write down the expression on comparing with the given terms. So in place of x1, I have a, x2, 2b, x3 is minus 3c, x4 is 2d, x5 value is 5. And on comparison, n value is 16. Right hand side, we substitute n value. So n is 16. So we get numerator 16 factorial. Yet we need to choose n1 to n5. So we write down them as it is. n1 factorial into n2 factorial into n3 factorial into n4 factorial into n5 factorial. So why five terms we have written factorials is because we have five terms in the required expansion. Multiplied by a power n1 because x1 value is a, 2b power n2 since x2 value is 2b, x3 value is minus 3c, so minus 3c whole power n3, x4 value is 2d, so 2d whole power n4, and the last term is x5, which is 5, so 5 power n5. Now, we'll first split the terms, the constant separate and the variable separate. Here a, b, c, d are the variables. So we have 2 power n2 minus 3 whole power n3 and 2 power n4, 5 power n5 as the constants powers. Multiplied by the variables, a power n1, b power n2, c power n3 and d power n4. Now our requirement is to find the coefficient of a square, b cube, c square, d power 5. So looking into our requirement, we are trying to choose the relevant values for n1 to n4. Of course, we also have to choose n5. So we want a square. So n1 value is chosen as 2. We need b cube. So n2 value is chosen as 3. We need c square, so n3 value should be chosen as 2. And finally, we need d power 5. So we have n4 value chosen as 5. And remember, we have 5 terms. So still we need to choose this 5 power n5. n5 also has to be chosen. And to choose that, we use the condition here. We have the basic condition for a multinomial theorem that sum of all n1, n2, n3, n4, n5 should be equal to n. Since we already know n1 to n4, we substitute them here. We already know n value from the given question, that is n value is 16. So since we can substitute n1, n2, n3, n4 as well as n, it will be easy for us to obtain or choose a particular value for n5. So n5 will be n minus of n1 plus n2 plus n3 plus n4. Substituting all the values, we obtain n5 is equal to 4. So we have all the values of the n1, n2, n3, n4, and n5, we substitute all these in the previous expression and obtain the coefficient of a square b cube c square d power 5. So we obtain the step 16 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 3 factorial into 2 factorial into 5 factorial into 4 factorial multiplied by 2 cube minus 3 whole square 2 power 5 5 power 4 a square b cube c square d power 5, which on simplification gives us 4.3589 into 10 power 4 multiplied by a square b cube c square d power 5. And thus the required coefficient will be 4.3589 into 10 power 14. So this is all about binomial and multinomial theorems. Hope you all followed and enjoyed this. Thank you.